The fishing news is brought to you by Shoreline Insurance, Navionics, Okuma, Yozuri, Evinrude, and the Star Island Yacht Club in Montauk, New York.
I can't believe we're nearly halfway through August already, and the fishing is holding up pretty well, despite what some call the summer doldrums. And it looks like another great weekend ahead. So let's check in with News 12 meteorologist Rich Von Olin.
Thanks, Tim. Hey, anglers, meteorologist Rich Von Olin here, News 12 Long Island Weather Center. Let's check the weekend forecast, see what we got going on. And I like what I see again. We're getting very lucky, it seems, this season with this weather forecast. Looks like another decent one. A little breeze on Saturday. We might have about 10 to 15 knots, maybe a good chop, again, close to shore, 2 to 4 offshore, 3 to 5 way offshore. The sound should be okay. If you want the calmer day, it looks like Sunday, a little less in the way of wave heights, more of a smoother ocean on Sunday. Probably the better day to do some offshore stuff. And see the winds on Saturday. Again, big high pressure building in right here. So we'll have more of a westerly breeze, maybe 10 to 15, maybe 18 knots at times. And then Saturday night, more of a westerly breeze, things will settle down a bit. I like Sunday a little better for the calmer ocean. A little more of a light northwest breeze as the high settling right overhead. And then more of a southwest breeze on the backside. So again, if I could pick a day on this weekend, I'd say Sunday would be the better one. And temperatures, not bad. Both Saturday and Sunday, we are looking at numbers in the 80s. And really not too tough to take. And we'll do the same thing on Sunday. So overall, good looking weekend forecast yet again. Enjoy. Get out there and do some fishing. I'm meteorologist Rich Von Olin on News 12 Long Island.
Remember to check in for the latest weather on News 12 before heading out. On the east end, there's still some nice bass being picked, like this one aboard Captain Scott Leonard's Top Gun on live bait. Same thing with fluke. Not a great bite, but there are nice fish to be had on the south side if you put your time in. Big bluefish have also moved into the Montauk area, and David Yeagerman has all the details.
Thanks, Tim. Hey guys, Dave Yeagerman here, the Salty Fly Rodders. I'm fishing with Captain Tim O'Rourke out in Montauk, and we've got tailing bluefish, gorilla bluefish out here. I'm with my two daughters, Isabel and Amanda. Everybody's hooked up. We're having a great time. I recommend you guys get out here, get a guide, fly guide, light tackle captain. It's going off here at night in the dusk hours.
Summer is here, so if you're in the market for a cooler for your boat or truck, one that is reasonably priced, holds ice for days, and made in the USA, check out Orca Coolers at Marine Mate in Lindenhurst. Now let's check in with Mike Dean.
Thanks, Tim. Just expected summer doldrums here around Shinnecock and Mariches. I feel like I can just see the same report for the inshore that I'm giving every week. Stripers at sunset, cocktail blues. The stripers are pretty small bucktails. Popper here and there will get you bluefish. Fluke bite in the bay, ton of sea robins, not too many keepers. The better fluke bite is out in the ocean on the reef, 60, 70 feet of water. If you can get out there, sea bass, a couple of knuckleheads coming up as well. Probably best bet if you're going during the day from the surf is just use a bunker chunk or some clams and hope for the best. Offshore though, for weeks I've been saying if you can get out there for this tuna bite. I finally got to get out there and it was awesome. A good buddy of mine, Adrian Muller, another buddy, Neil. The three of us headed out, broke Shinnecock Inlet about 4:45 a.m. A little bit 2 hour and change ride out to Quambra. Ton of life, porpoises, whales, a lot of birds. We didn't hook up with anything after about a half hour of fishing and some reports came over the radio. There were some fish about 10 miles away, so we made the run, well rewarded for it. About 7 or 8 boats there, everybody was into fish. About every 20 minutes, half hour, somebody was tight. We were using pink knife jigs. Speed jigging did not produce any fish for us. We were just yo-yoing off the bottom. That's how we got our two unders and an over. We did get tight with one other fish that we lost pretty quick. Just absolutely amazing being out there. I've never caught a bluefin before. What a fight. Never expected it to be that tough of a fight. Teamwork got that fish to the boat and real memorable one for me. So real great week of fishing. Get out there this weekend and fish. You never know what's gonna come up on the end of the line.
Captain Al Lorenzetti checked in with the report that larger fluke have moved into the Fire Island area this past week. He put Carl and Millicent Kersey on some nice fluke, with the biggest weighing in at 8 pounds. The bigger fish seem to be taking live peanut bunker. The West End Report is brought to you by Rachel's Waterside Grill on the Nautical Mile in Freeport. You hook it, they will cook it. and just for $12 per entree. Call 516-546-0050 for details. Last week, I did just that. I had my sea bass blackened with a tomato Creole cream sauce, and it was amazing. Now let's check in with Joey Leggio.
Hey, Tim, what's going on? Deb's in it. Let's talk about it. The bottom fishing, that's what's going on out of my inlet right now. All the reefs, McAllister, AB, Rockaway, all those reefs have fish. There's tons of porgies to be caught. There's sea bass, there's fluke. I had out Rich from News 12 yourself. We were out on Friday. You know what happened out there. It was nonstop. We were catching flukes, jumbo porgies. We had sea bass, lots and lots of action. Of course, you have your other mixed in fish. We had some squirrel hake, some ling. You see robins, of course, are always out there. The reefs are loaded. It's a lot of fun, and again, it's great for the kids. Get the kids out there. It's very simple. High-low rigs, clam, you're gonna catch fish. A couple days later, I went out with one of my buddies, drifting around to pieces again. We had a strong east wind, east tide, and we were ripping, but it was still catching a fluke. A lot of short bites, as the drift was probably doing 1.2 miles an hour. But a nice surprise we had on that day, we had a nice cobia that hit the bucktail. On the Spro bucktail, tipped with a Berkeley Gulp pink shine, had a just over keeper, 37 and a quarter inch cobia, and a great fish, especially great to see him up here in New York on our reefs. A lot of fun. It was actually my first. I've been waiting a long time for that one, but we had him. It was great. The offshore scene still is like these tuna are never gonna stop. All my buddies are out there and they're still crushing tuna. I mean, this is probably the strongest run of tuna I think I've seen in a long time. Basically, that's really it, though. Again, the reefs, that's where it's at. Hit those reefs, you're gonna catch fish.
Look for the link at the end of this broadcast for his porgy filleting video. If you're looking for a quality fish boat that's affordable, check out a C-Pro powered by Suzuki. For less than $400 a month, get you into all the action. Visit Kale's Family Boating Center for a test ride today. Now let's check in with Mike Sentry from Staten Island.
Thanks, Tim. Hey, Fisherman, Mike Sentry here. Well, last Friday, I hit the AP for some tuna jigging. Using the Shimano butterfly jigs, bouncing them right off the bottom. What can I say, guys? Look, every single tuna that we hooked on, it broke off because we were using only 30 pound monofilament, light line. And the hammerhead, the common reef sharks, the black tips, they were everywhere. So not a good combination. We lost quite a few to some sharks. A lot of activity out there. So it's definitely an early morning bite. And from what I gather from my friends, it's an afternoon bite around noon. Lunchtime, what can you say? As far as fluking wise goes, the Ocean Explorer has been doing very well off the ocean side. He's been catching some really nice doormats. Where he's at is about 55 to 60 feet of water using some jigs, the 4-inch to 6-inch gulps. What else can I say? Let's see, bluefish, cocktails are in the bay. The pufferfish, a lot of them in the rock piles. Porgies are finally here. My friend went out, literally slaughtered the porgies, bucket full. So get out there, guys. Enjoy yourself. Have some fun. Summer's here. Enjoy.
From Cow Harbor Bait and Tackle, let's hear from Mark McGowan.
Hey, everybody knows what last weekend was like, and it was tough fishing. We had a lot of wind against tide situations, but we're talking about the weekend coming up, and I think it's going to be great. Fluke have moved in the Cold Spring area, 15, buoy 15 area, which means that they're going to be heading west again. This was this past weekend. We brought in some nice keepers to the shop, and that's always great to see. If you're looking, you're in the Port Washington area, definitely keep a heads up. If you're in the North Port Huntington area, try heading west and just do some nice drifts. I would even go as far as Execution Rocks. These fluke are definitely going to be around. The porgy fishing is red hot, so that's great for bringing in guests or friends. I know some people, after a while, they go, I've had enough porgies, but remember, there's plenty of opportunities out there, and it's August, so you got to make the time the best that you can. So go out there and fish. There's plenty of other fish around them. You'll pull up occasional doormat fluke around them, so that's fantastic. Also, there's been tons of snappers around, and that's great news for people on the beach and the docks, and as well as on the boat. You just bring the simple stuff, spearing squid, lures, snapper, popper, doesn't matter. They're on it, and they're pretty hungry, and I think this is probably going to go on right through past Labor Day, so that's a great news too. Striped bass, I have not caught any recently. It seems like they might have slowed down because of these temperatures, but some guys have been catching them, and that's usually a late at night thing. Also, plenty of sand sharks. These sand sharks, you know, love to twist themselves up in the line. They love bunker and they love clams. So if you're chunking for bass or blues, you're most likely going to encounter them. Use a D-hooker, it's pretty good. Remember, they don't have any teeth up here, so don't stick your finger in there, but also take caution to remember to get the hook out and treat them right. That's about it for this week's report, and I look to see you out next time.
Aloha, Hawaiian Dan.
Thanks, Tim. Aloha! I'm Hawaiian Dan of TalkFishTV.com, reporting for the Fisherman magazine. Ninja'd up, as we should be in the summertime, because there are plenty of insects out, and they want a piece of you. And I gotta say, the bite on the central north shore of Long Island is still super hot. It's easy to score that summer slam of a striper, fluke, bluefish, and porgies. Four separate outings, four separate slams for me. Starting to give myself a little anxiety because I'm pressuring myself to score it every time now, and if I can do it, so can you. So remember, get off those couches, grab your family and friends, and get out there and fish. Remember to spread as much aloha as you can, and until next week, this is Hawaiian Dan of TalkFishTV.com reminding you that no matter where you are in the world, you can choose to live that island life. Aloha.
The green flies love this hot weather, and so do those biting black flies. If you're looking for an all-natural solution to protect you from these pests, try Captain Ron's, made from pure plant extract, so it smells great and it's safe too. Captain Kirk Fay is back with an offshore report.
Thanks, Tim. On Sunday, I ran my boat to the tails. We struck out as far as tuna goes. We ended up catching a few small mahi. About 3 o'clock, I was desperate to put a tuna in the box, so we headed towards the Coimbra. About 10 miles southeast of the Coimbra, I got this huge whiff of a fish feed. I know that sounds crazy, but you can smell it. Pull back on the throttle. My buddy Chris next to me started screaming, "Look at all the tuna chicks." It was that slick, greasy looking water. We immediately set up again trolling. We zigzagged back and forth for 45 minutes. Couldn't get a bite. We got lucky. We hooked up with a mahi that made us clear some lines. And at that point, I said, listen, let's try to jig and pop. So we were dropping down Ronzies. We were dropping down metal jigs. And I was throwing a popper. And sure enough, I connected with a fish over 100 pounds on a popper. By the end of the day, we actually ended up catching 3 more bluefin all on poppers. So it's one of those great things. Just basically don't give up. You never know when that bite's going to occur. And it did for us. And I can't wait to get back out there.
Also from the deep, Captain Matt Fitz of Neptune Charters trolled up and released his hatchet marlin, which is usually found in the eastern Atlantic. Then he made a stop at the canyon for a few beautiful tilefish like this one. With all the surf action, let's check in with senior editor Fred Golofaro.
Hey, Tim. Yeah, and some encouraging reports coming from particularly the East End this week, where there were a number of decent bass caught on the south side of Montauk at night, plugs and eels, fish between 30 and 40 pounds. A lot of bunker along that stretch, so hopefully the bait sticks around and some of those bigger fish stay along the beach. Bluefish still on the north side pretty much every day. You know, occasionally there's an off day, but they're a pretty sure bet there too. As far as bluefish around the rest of the island, some bigger bluefish did show up in Fire Island this past weekend. And also, there's a lot of cocktail blues in places like Mauritius Inlet and Shinnecock Inlet also. Also hearing of some blues and some bass, in fact, up on the North Fork. All that makes the East End, again, probably the place to concentrate your efforts for the most part. Along most of the South Shore with sharks, rays, some really big rays. Also some kingfish, guys, you know, dropping down to smaller hooks using squid or clams for bait or worms. Have a shot at some kingfish, decent number of them around apparently. And around the inlets, there's also some hits and misses with bonita. And hopefully it won't be too long before the albies show up. Ocean temperatures are way up there, so I have a feeling they might show up a little early this year, but we'll see. This weekend is the Libby Jamboree. That's Saturday, starts at 9:30, runs right through the evening. There's food, games, live music in the evening. It's a lot of fun, great event, there's raffles, and I'll be there part of the day anyway, so stop by, say hello, and it's free to members as long as your dues are up to date, $5 for non-members, but that's a great reason to sign up right there at the show, and your dues are good right through 2020 if you sign up at the Jamboree. Don't forget about the Fisherman Surf Inshore Show. That's September 19th at the Huntington Hilton. That's a great night. I've got some really good speakers lined up. We got Alberto Nye, John Skinner, Bill Wetzel, Matt Broderick, Crazy Al, Doc Mueller. It should be a good time. 500 goodie bags for the first 500 attendees. Great raffle, a lot of great prizes. Everybody gets a free ticket. You're welcome to buy a few more if you want, but everyone starts with a free ticket, and hope to see everybody there. And just a side note, it was Shark Week last week, so I don't want to play this up too much, but I thought it was very interesting that three different incidents this past weekend on the south side of Montauk. John Bruno had a 50-inch bass bit in half by a shark. Another caster had two 10 to 12 footers cruising by in front of his rock. And another caster told Ken at Tightlines Bait and Tackle he had to beat off a 7-foot shark with the butt of his rod. We all know there's a lot more sharks around, a lot more brown sandbar sharks, a lot more sand tigers. They're protected, you know, nobody's killing them. And there are a lot of them along the South Shore and out east now. But also a lot more great whites due to all the seals in Montauk now. That continues to be a problem, the seals that is, and with the seals come great whites. So, word to the wise, you know. As far as skishing goes, no thanks, not me. Till next week, Fred Golofaro here for thefisherman.com.
Paul McCain is on the road again with a fly report.
Hello, Tim. We've been up here on the Housatonic, a short drive from Long Island, fish for smallmouth. And in the evening, I had terrific luck using this little foam popper that we tie at the shop. 15 of us, over 60 fish caught. I thought that was a good day. Now, to get on Long Island, Carp Fred has been fishing the little puddles right by my house, little tiny ponds, fishing with his Freddy's bird fly. He's doing very well. Surprisingly, it's still holding up. We're still getting a lot of good reports of bass and bluegills in all the fresh water. Of course, the Connecticut, the Carmen's River, best time to fish the Carmen's is very early in the day before it warms up. But it has fish hatches all summer long. Good time to get out there. Salt water, we've been doing really well. Montauk reports big bluefish, choppers, back bays. There are bluefish still in the back bays right by my house over by Jones Beach. It's going to be a terrific summer. I'm looking forward to the fall. I can't wait to get my boat out there. Tight lines, everybody, and get out there while you can.
Remember, like our video, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and tap on the bell to be notified instantly when we post a new video on YouTube. And of course, be a subscriber to the Fisherman Magazine to be part of the Dream Boat Contest. And until next week, this is Tim C. Smith for thefisherman.com.